Dear 10-year-old Eric, you just found out your dad is gay. You asked him plainly on the front porch in the way only a chilled out, born and raised Californian could. Dad, are you gay? Yes. Who are you gay with? I'm not gay with anybody. You must have looked confused because he went on to explain, you don't have to be gay with someone to be gay. You can just be gay. Oh, you said, cool. Knowing this changed nothing in how you feel about your dad. It's just another truth you have to learn, like Santa Claus isn't real, or you have this invisible thing called muscular dystrophy. Well, now add dad's gay to the list. But don't worry. In time, you'll realize that being gay is probably the least complicated thing about your father. Now for some bad news. In a little less than a year, you will break your femurs skateboarding. I know what you're thinking, but sadly, no. The trick you attempt is not awesome, nor is it at all worth the excruciating pain you'll experience. Still, you'll eventually walk away with a gnarly scar and quite a tale to tell with it. And more than that, you'll learn that accidents like this one have the uncanny power to bring people together, and that even seemingly mortal enemies like your mom and dad can make amends over time. So after 4 weeks in the hospital with nearly endless deliveries of A&W chicken sandwiches and Tomatina's garlic knots, 2 dozen Nintendo 64 games that your sister's boyfriend will temporarily loan you, and the only VCR in the entire hospital, you'll be released in a partial body cast and start 5th grade as the coolest kid in school. When you get back on your feet, one of those other truths will become real for you, this invisible thing called muscular dystrophy. You will need more support from your arms to do things like stand up from the floor or from a low couch. You'll be a little slower during basketball and kickball games. It might not seem like much now, but it'll be enough to prompt you to ask your basketball coach if you can address the entire team to tell them you have muscular dystrophy so they understand your limitations. For several years, you will see muscular dystrophy as the enemy, and you will fight it, and you will measure your self-worth only in how effectively you can overcome this unseen force or how much you can inspire others with your valiant attempts. But something magical will happen when you're 17. You and your stepdad will take a cross-country road trip, and you'll find an entire community of people just like you, people with disabilities. But they won't be anything like the tragic, weak people you might imagine. These people are proud of the community they are a part. They wear their disabilities like badges of honor. They say the word disability because it feels good to say. They protest and even get arrested if necessary because they recognize that their greatest limitations come from the society around them, not from the differences that color who they are. These people will become your new heroes, and you'll be practically begging for a power wheelchair by the time you're 18. Learning to love your disability will make you strong enough to work through the greater challenges that lie ahead. So have fun, take some risks. Fail miserably, go outside and wander aimlessly. Get an instrument and make some noise. Get 10 instruments, make some more. Fall in love again and again because the right woman will enter your life at the right time. But most importantly, love yourself. Your life is a wild adventure and you have just begun. So live it up, kid.
For more information on the Opening Minds, Opening Doors project, please visit our website at www.vsatx.org/omod or call us toll-free at 1-866-489-8412.